guys, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another big unboxing here at BNC IRC. Got a box here from Hobby Recreation Products. You might have heard me talk about that a little bit in recent videos. They're the main distributors in the U.S. for Cross RC, Charisma, HPI, and probably a bunch of other brands that I can't think of because I haven't bought any of yet. Just been in a mood lately to spend my money on them other brands instead of giving it all to Horizon Hobbies. Nothing against Horizon, I just don't like them having a stranglehold on my hobby. Let's see here. This is not another Charisma. And it's not another HPI. I do have another HPI coming from them. Kind of odd. I ordered the HPI thing from them on Friday. And I ordered this other thing, which I hope is the right thing, on Sunday. And this was due to get here today. The other thing is due to be here on Friday. And they actually tried to deliver this yesterday. I don't even know how the fuck it got here from Salt Lake City in 2 days. Oh, baby. We have got the Demon SP4C from Cross RC. On the box, it says SP4C flagship version, whatever that means. Not going to be much of an unboxing because it's a kit. If it's anything like the Demon SR4 that I built, about a year ago, that thing was fantastic. But on that one, I went for the cheapest version. I went with the Lexan bodied. It was a real reasonable price, and it worked fantastic. I've compared notes with other guys that have Demons, and come to the conclusion that I think the Lexan ones, they're going to come down. There goes the fucking light again. Works better than the hard-bodied ones. But I'm a glutton for punishment, and I went for the hard-bodied version. Wow, there's a lot of shit on that box. I'll just give you a good look at that box. It's like a pickup. Hard-bodied, supposed to be. We'll see what she's made of. I think there's a lot of metal in this son of a bitch. Because this box is pretty heavy. Heaviest RC box I've picked up in a long time. I've got 8 scale aluminum frame bashers that aren't as heavy as this thing is. Pretty excited about it. Yep. She's hard body, alright. Here's our instruction manual. It'll be my best friend for a little while. Now when I did the Demon SR4, a lot of that was pre-assembled. The axles, the motor, and transmission were together and put together right. And I remember I took one of the axles apart to make sure it had grease in it, and it was built fantastic. Hard body, we got bumpers and a lot of scale detail stuff. Stuff to build shocks. Shocks look pretty small. I remember the Demons did too. And they worked fantastic. Steering wheel. Rubber mud flaps, windshield wipers, the doors. Yep, that's doors and inner door panels. I believe this has a full interior. There's a metal roll cage for the back of the body. That's a roof for the roll cage, or maybe it could double as a tonneau cover. Holy fuck, there's a lot of bags in here. This is one of them deals where it's never getting back in this box. There's a little plastic. That looks like the front. Oh, that's probably the piece that goes inside the body to mount that cage to. I'm not sure. I'm just guessing. Inner fenders. All metal axles. They're heavier than a bastard. And they are a good looking axle. They're not even in a regular sealed bag. They're in a Ziploc bag. That's a pretty nice axle right there. Looks like aftermarket stuff. I dig it. We got some tires with foams. I really like the Black Rocks that came with the Demon, but I think I read that these come with something else. Holy shit, they're bagged up there. Oh man, they feel fantastic. Mud crawlers, they call them. They are super squishy. Pretty wide. I don't know if I like the looks of wide tires. It looks like there's a lot of foam in there. But, God, that tread is so squishy. I don't think I'll need to chop the foams up like I did on the Demon. Maybe I didn't need to do it on the Demon either. I just did it because I like to fuck with stuff. Oh, we got LED lights. And a Dean's plug to Dean's plug adapter. There's the Cross RC 35 turn motor with the gear reduction box, aka transmission, with the all metal transfer case. I think the Demon had a plastic case, and that looks like cast. Pretty cool stuff. Oh my God. What else have you got in here? Shock oil and grease. Really good looking drive shafts. Those are nice drive shafts. There's some excellent quality stuff. I love the drive shafts that Demon came with too. Here's the frame rails. Oh boy, there's a lot of shit here. A whole bunch of sticky tape. I think that's the skid plate, maybe. All metal. I think those are the metal rock sliders. Bag of metal links. A whole shitload of hardware in that little bag there. Chrome grill. There's a piece of screen to go behind the grill. Chrome light buckets. Oh my Lord. I have never opened a kit that came with wheels like that. They look pretty fucking fantastic. I don't think I'll need to order training wheels for this sumbitch. Wow. Daddy likes it. Oh my God, that shit is never gonna fit back in this box. There's another little bag of hardware. This must be the body. That box is pretty heavy too. I am running out of room here. Hope that camera's still rolling. Oh, no tape on this. Oh, buddy. There's the pickup box. Battery goes right down in the box, it looks like. That is pretty cool. Here's the cab. The cab is exactly the same as the Demon, but it has a pickup box instead of the truggy back half. That's pretty cool. If you ever change your mind, it probably wouldn't take a hell of a lot to go to the truggy look with this if you so chose to. There's an imitation motor plate and the hood. There's all the windows and colored lenses for the signal lights. Link ends. Decals for the dash. This has a lit dash, if I remember correctly. There's an interior floor panel. The seats. Those are window trim, I believe. It's going to be a fucking project. I'm not even going to get this part back in the box. Now, white bumpers again. I wish it came with metal bumpers. A white dash and white bumpers. But I painted the bumpers last time, and they looked pretty good when I was done. I was pretty happy with that. I guess that's it. That's what's in the box. That whole pile of shit was in that little box. Oh my goodness. Kind of a daunting project. Yeah, I knew this was going to be a problem. There's no fucking way they were both in there. Oh my God. Go with instructions on how to get back in the fucking box. Alright. My shop is officially a clusterfuck. Well, that's what you get when you go for the big dog. Through HRP, I got it at the end of the Black Friday deal. I think the original price was $650 for this. And I paid $439, if my memory serves correctly. Saved quite a bit of money. Still spent more than I usually like to, but looking at this box, I think it was worth it. There's a lot of good quality shit in here. I guess I gotta build something. Sorry, Docs, I'm going to have to break doctor's orders. I'm going to start turning a screwdriver on this son of a bitch. Just the way it's got to be. Bye-bye.